Hi folks, my name is Mario Peach and today I want to show you another possibility how to create new titlers with the GitHub web UI. Yeah, so with the latest beta version, Jeremy introduced a new titler which asks for help to improve the TiddlyWiki documentation. Okay, so there are already two videos which show how to edit an existing titler and a little bit about general information about the GitHub UI. So we click Jeremolin here, the link which should open Jeremy's TiddlyWiki 5 let's say page, main page, and then we enter TiddlyWiki 5 repository. In normal cases, if you want to create new titlers, you should also start from Jeremy's master branch because it contains the latest information. And because if you start from your own page, your master branch may be outdated. So always start from Jeremy's master branch. Okay, we say we want to edit something from the TiddlyWiki5.com editions. So we enter the titlers path. Then Jeremy has structured it in the way that it's mainly with tags. So there is the how-to tag, and yesterday I showed you already how to create a pull request for the importing TiddlyWiki documentation, improving TiddlyWiki documentation. And as you can see already, Jeremy has changed it already, so he has included the first video. Okay. So how to's, and as you can see there is a plus sign which makes it possible to create a new titler. I'm not logged in at the moment, so it tells me I should be logged in, so you need to create a new account or use your existing account, and then you are able to create a new titler. So I say this is a new titler from the GitHub web UI. Okay. So we need a title here. This is should be the same title. Then we have the tags, which is called how to. And then I'll have a look at the others. So copy the whole stuff. Control C. Control V. Okay. There is the created timestamp. In this case it's from the 20th, so we have 31st and we have 1649, and then there are 5 zeros. Okay, we use this, oops, set the driver again here, then this is a titler. New titler created with the GitHub web UI. Okay, so that's it. Then you can give it a different title if you want, but default is fine. Propose a new file. What will it do? It creates from Jeremy's master branch, it creates a feature branch in my repository. So in PMario, there is now the page 2. And it would be possible to create the pull request. But I don't want to create the pull request for only one file, I want to create different, or let's say several files. Okay, so I'm at my repository already, so and now I can continue because there is already a page 2 branch which is based on the latest Jeremy's master branch. I can continue with my own repository. So say editions, tiddlywiki5.com, titlers how to, and there should be a new titler from the GitHub web UI, sorry. Okay, I copy the content and I create a new one. Let's say this is the second titler. I did copy the whole content, so it's less typing. Good. The title, and this is the second titler created with the web UI. Okay. commit. Now you have seen there is a button which says commit because I'm already in my repository. Okay, now let's compare the two repositories. There you can see the information. It says this branch is two commits ahead from Germolin master. I could create a pull request or I can say compare. So I say compare and then I can see what I changed. And with this mechanism you have the possibility to create 3, 4, 5 tillers, as many tillers as you want. Then when you're finished you can say create the pull request, which I don't do at the moment, but I say okay, give Jeremy some information, new documentation about, I don't know, and then you give some info what you did and why it is important. Then you can say create the pull request, and then you just need to follow the communication with Jeremy. This pull request or this branch can be used for several changes, as I did describe in the second video or in the first video. Even if you did create the pull request and you make some new tiddlers or some changings, then this will be added to the pull request, so Jeremy can merge all the stuff in one go. But there's still, let's say, one limitation. Just put as many tiddler into one pull request as are really needed. So don't throw 100 tiddlers to Jeremy, because it will be difficult to merge. So let's say 2, 3, 4, 5 tiddlers are okay, so that are needed for describing one function, and then you can create a new pull request for a different feature. Yeah, that's it. I hope you like it. Have fun. Yeah, there is one thing. Don't forget to star Jeremy's branch or Jeremy's repository. So if you have star here, then click it so the counter should go up to 1000. Okay, have fun.